Hello friends, how are you? I hope you are good. Today we are going to start a new chapter, chemistry of proteins. The chemistry of carbohydrate and lipids we have already completed. Now the new chapter is chemistry of proteins. Now in this chapter we will see first the introduction of the proteins. What are proteins? So friends, now we'll start the new chapter, that is chemistry of protein. Now here we'll see the introduction first. In the introduction we'll see the how, what is meant by proteins. So proteins are the compounds, or they are the organic substances formed by the union of amino acid linked by peptide chains. So they are the molecules. Protein molecules are the union of amino acids formed by the peptide chains. Many amino acids comes together and they form a protein molecule. Here first of all we must know, proteins are first reported by the scientist known as Berzelius in the year 1883. The meaning of proteos in Greek word is first place, means the first substance found in nature. So you must know that proteos means the first substance or first place of the substance which is formed in the nature. Now you must know that the proteins are also said to be biopolymer of L-alpha amino acids. They are useful for the formation of the new cells in our body, as well as they repair the cells in our body. Now you must know, proteins are the structural components and functional units of the living organisms. They are present in animals, plants and microorganisms. So you must know that the 1/5 of the proteins constitute the total body weight of an adult in the body. So here the proteins are nothing but they are the structural and component, structural and functional units of the living organism. So here these proteins, they use thousands of amino acids in our body during the hydrolysis. Whenever the hydrolysis of proteins takes place, number of amino acids are formed. So you must know, these two peptides comes together and they form a bond between them known as peptide bond. It is also known as amide bond. In such a way, the polypeptides are formed in the body, in the structure of the protein. And you must know, protein have a definite shape, size, and it will be of polar or non-polar nature. So you must know that proteins, which are also known as the organic substances, high molecular compounds, and the linear chain of amino acids will form polypeptides in the body. So you must know that this is some introduction about the protein. Now you must know, among the 300 amino acids which are formed in nature, only 20 amino acids are important, which are related with the protein formation, and they are said to be the normal proteins or the primary amino acids. Or you must know that they are said to be normal amino acids or primary amino acids or standard amino acids. These 20 amino acids, they take part in the formation of protein molecule in our body. So here this is the some introduction about the protein. Now you must know, the different types of proteins are present in our body. They are the fibrous proteins and the globular proteins, and another one is the membrane protein. So these are the types of proteins which are present in our body or in the living organism. So you must know that the proteins which are in fiber form, they are said to be the fibrous protein. They are simply fiber in nature. So here you must know this fibrous protein is elongated one, strong, and they give protection, and external protection is provided to the tissues, and they are said to be the fibrous protein. They are just fiber like structure having. So these proteins are water insoluble, or they are not soluble in water. So here if you see the examples of this fibrous protein, they are collagen present in the cartilages and tendons. What are tendons? Tendons are soft tissues which attach muscles to the bones. So you must know. The other example is skin, blood vessels, teeth. So these are the examples of the fibrous proteins in our body, and these fibrous proteins, they are also present in the extracellular matrix. So here this is the fibrous proteins which are fiber in nature, elongated, and they are present in the hair and nails also. Keratin, a protein which is present in the hair, which give strength, which gives the power or to the hair, and the hair becomes strong, and it gives the stretchability to the hair. If you see that in many women, they maintain their hairs with the help of the shampoos which are used by the women to keep the hair strong, healthy, and black. So you must know that these are the fibrous proteins which are present in the extracellular matrix and collagen. Now we'll see these proteins they are having fiber in shape. The another protein called as globular protein. Globular proteins are rounded in shape, and you must know that these globular proteins are seen, for example, albumin and globulin. If you observe under the microscope the structure of these proteins, they are rounded in shape, and the albumin are smaller than the globulins. So you must know that they are rounded in shape. And what is the role of these globular proteins in our body? They play biological activity, and they also play an important carrier of the oxygen towards the different tissues. So you must know that hemoglobin is one of the example of fibrous protein which carry oxygen from lungs towards the different tissue of the body. And the another important is insulin. Insulin play an important role in our body to maintain blood glucose concentration. The blood glucose concentration, the normal range fasting blood sugar is 180 to 120 milligram percent, and the post meal blood sugar is 120 to 180 milligram percent. So this blood sugars are maintained in the body by the insulin, the hormone. So you must know that the thousands of amino acids are present in a protein molecule, but the exception is that insulin will have only 51 amino acids. So here the insulin will have two different polypeptides, A polypeptide and B polypeptide. In A polypeptide, 21 amino acids are present, and in B polypeptide, 331 amino acids are present, means totally 51 amino acids are present in insulin. But here, the in definition, if we'll see the structure or the meaning of the protein, thousands of amino acids comes together and they form a protein molecule. But exception case is here, only 51 amino acids are present in the insulin. So this is an exception case. So here you must know that these amino acids in insulin, they will form a disulfide bond with cysteine amino acid. The two chain polypeptide chains are present in insulin, polypeptide A, polypeptide B, 21 amino acids and 30 amino acids. So here you must know that the total 51 amino acids are present in the insulin and they form a disulfide bond with cysteine amino acid. Cysteine will form the disulfide bond in the insulin. So you must know that the amino acids will also form the disulfide bond in the insulin. So here we'll have seen the introduction and now we'll see the formation or what is the synthesis, what substances are synthesized in the body from the protein. So first of all, you must know that in the protein, enzymes are formed. The enzymes like trypsin and pepsin, these are called as proteolytic enzyme, they are formed in the body. And proteins are also used for the synthesis of hormones, and proteins are also carry the role of carrier. I just now told you, hemoglobin will just transport the oxygen from lungs to the several parts of the tissues in our body. So here you must know, and the some contractile proteins known as myosin and actin, they are very useful for the contraction of the muscles. So proteins are used here. So you must know that the another that skin of melanin is a pigment which is formed by the skin, is also formed by proteins. And proteins are very helpful to give the structure to the tissues. So here you must know that proteins are also useful for the formation of antibodies. You must know that antibodies are the proteins which carry the function of immunization. So proteins are also used for the formation of the nucleic acids. The nucleic acid like DNA. What is my DNA? Deoxyribonucleic acid. What is RNA? Ribonucleic acid. So proteins are used for the formation of DNA as well as RNA. These are the nucleic acid. Proteins are also used for the formation of nucleotides. The nucleotides like purine, pyrimidine. Now you must know, these are the uses of the proteins in our body for the formation of different substances. So you must know that the types of proteins we have seen already. Fibrous protein, then globular protein. The another type is membrane protein. In membrane protein, that is the integral protein is there, which diverge the structure and position in the cell membrane. And the peripheral protein, which is present in the cell membrane transiently. And the another protein that is said to be transport protein. And it transports the ions and molecules from outside to inside, inside to outside of the cell. So here, these are the three different types of we have seen, and we have seen the uses of proteins also. Now we will see the structure of amino acid. So here it is a structure of amino acid. In the center, a carbon atom is present, and this carbon atom is called as alpha carbon atom. Now this alpha carbon atom will attach to the four different groups. Here the COOH, that is carboxylic acid, NH2 amino group, R group is there and hydrogen molecule is there, hydrogen atom is there. So this R group is variable for different amino acids. Now you must know that it is a asymmetric carbon atom. Alpha carbon, it is said to be asymmetric carbon atom. Why it is said to be asymmetric carbon atom? Because it has four different groups in its structure: carboxylic group, amino group, R group and H group. Now if you see this in our body, only L type of amino acids are present. Now here we'll see D and L form of amino acids. So here this NH2 is present towards the left side and it is said to be L amino acid, and the NH2 is present towards the right side, it is said to be the D amino acid. So here this is D L alanine and this is D alanine. Now if you see the structure of glycine, glycine do not show any optical activity. So we will see the structure of glycine. At R group, a hydrogen atom is present here. So here COOH carboxylic group, NH2 amino group, hydrogen and hydrogen. It is nothing but glycine. This glycine do not show optical rotation. So you must know, and they do not form any D and L enantiomer. So you must know, since this glycine having two hydrogen atoms in the asymmetric carbon atom. So you must know that. Now we'll see, friends, we'll see here the classification of amino acid. Here a flow chart is given here for the classification of amino acid. Now here you must know, see, amino acid, they are classified as hydrophilic, called as polar, and another one hydrophobic, known as non-polar. So meaning of this hydrophilic polar, first we'll see. This hydrophilic polar amino acids are subdivided into 3, 1, 2, 3, means negatively charged amino acid and the positively charged amino acid. So negatively charged amino acid, they are acidic amino acids, and positively charged amino acid, they are basic amino acids. Now the uncharged, which are said to be neutral amino acids, and here the third one is uncharged amino acid here. Now you can see here, if you first we'll see the negatively charged amino acids here. Example, aspartic acid and glutamic acid. Now the positively charged amino acids are lysine, arginine and histidine, and the uncharged, which is said to be neutral amino acid, they are serine, threonine, then aspargine, and here glycine, cysteine and glutamine and glycine. So here the uncharged neutral amino acids are serine, threonine, aspargine, glutamine, cysteine and glycine. Now here these are the hydrophilic amino acids. So you must know, if anybody wants to define what are amino acids, So you must define it. Amino acids are aminocarboxylic acids. Amino acids are aminocarboxylic acid. So you must know that the hydrophilic polar acids are aspartic acid and glutamic acid. The positively charged are lysine, arginine, histidine. They are positively charged. They are said to be basic amino acid. And in neutral, we have seen that. Now, the another part of the classification is hydrophobic nonpolar. Now, here, these hydrophobic nonpolar polar amino acids are also subdivided into aliphatic chain, aliphatic side chain, and aromatic side chain. So, here you must know the hydrophobic nonpolar amino acids. First, we'll see aliphatic side chain amino acid. These are alanine, valine, lysine, isoleucine, proline, and methionine. These are the aliphatic. These amino acids having the side chain in the aliphatic. They are having aliphatic side chain in the molecule. So you must know they are the hydrophobic. And the another part is aromatic side chain. The hydrophobic nonpolar, or we can say the those amino acids which do not interact with the water, and hydrophilic interacts with the water. So this the amino acids which do not interact with the water, they are aliphatic and aromatic. Now the aromatic side chain amino acids are tryptotyrosine, tryptophan, phenylalanine. So you must know these are the classification of amino acids: hydrophobic, hydrophilic, hydrophobic. Under hydrophilic, negatively charged, positively charged, uncharged. Under hydrophobic, aliphatic side chain, aromatic side chain. Now you must know here only a very special difference is here. Histidine is positively charged amino acid as well as it is aliphatic side chain containing amino acids. So you must know that. Sorry. So it is positively charged amino acid as well as it is aromatic side chain amino acid. So histidine is kept in both the groups, under positively charged and under aromatic side chain. So you must know this is the classification of the amino acid. Now we'll see what are hydroxy amino acid. The hydroxy amino acid means that the OH group will be present in the structure of amino acid is said to be hydroxy amino acid. Here, see here, CH2CH2COOH, and amide group is there in the amino acid, and carboxylic group is also present. Along with this, OH is an additional one. So it is the hydroxy amino acid which are seen in serine. The symbol for serine is S, and it is also present in tyrosine. The hydroxyl amino acid is also present in tyrosine. The another group of amino acid is sulfur containing amino acid. Sulfur containing amino acids are two amino acids are there: cysteine, cysteine, and methionine. Later on, we'll see how the cysteine will produce cysteine in the body. Now, these are the two amino acids which will have SH group in its structure. Here, CH2CHCOOH. SH is here. See here. The additional one is SH. Means the amino acids which will have sulfur in its structure is said to be sulfur containing amino acid. Cysteine and methionine. Now we'll see the diamino acid. Diamino acids means two amino groups are there, means one additional amino group will be there in the structure along with the already which is present in the amino acid, that is NH3. So here the additional NH3 will be there. It is said to be diamino acid. And the example is lysine. The symbol of lysine is K, and these diamino acids are also present in the arginine. Now you must know that the symbol of the arginine is R. Now you will see the dicarboxylic acid. What is that? Dicarboxylic acid. Dicarboxylic acid means here in the amino structure, two carboxylic acids will be present there. See here, COO minus, means these are the carboxylic acid. Two carboxylic acid are present. Example, glutamic acid. The symbol of glutamic acid is E, and it is also present. The dicarboxylic acids are also present in glutamine. The symbol of glutamine is E, aspargine R, and aspartic acid D. So you must know that these are the dicarboxylic acid. Now the another example of this, or the another group of amino acids, are amino acids. The another group of amino acids, they are amino. The meaning of amino acids means it will have, see, in the amino acid NH2 is present as a base. So this will have one hydrogen atom less. Therefore, it is said to be amino acid. Here the example is there. CH2CH COO, that is carboxylic acid, and this is the amino group. Only NH is present here instead of NH2. Therefore, it is said to be amino acid. The example of amino acid is proline, which is having the symbol P. So it will have one less carbon atom in its structure. So you must know that the amino acids is the amino acids which are having one less hydrogen atom. Now we'll see what are essential amino acids. Essential amino acids, the definition, if you want to define essential amino acid, you have to define essential amino acids are those amino acids which are not synthesized in the body, but we get it from the diet. So you must know that the essential amino acids are the amino acids which we do not get it, or which are not synthesized in our body, but we get it from the diet. So what are those? These amino acids are also known as indispensable amino acid. Indispensable amino acids. So here the essential amino acids are also known as indispensable amino acids. So here you must know that these are the amino acids which are said to be essential. We get it from the diet, and they are not synthesized in our body. So if we want to write the name of these essential amino acid, we can write in short also, that is PVT, team. Hall. If you do not know the, if you do not remember the names, you have to write in short. P, not in the examination, but for your remembrance, you have to just remember like this. In full form, you have to write in the examination. P means proline, V means valine, T means threonine, and this is tryptophan, isoleucine, methionine, histidine, alanine, leucine, lysine. So you must know, this is a short form for the essential amino acid. Now we'll see the non-essential amino acid. What is meaning of non-essential amino acids? Before that, I forgot to tell you that these essential amino acids, they are required in our body for the growth of the child. So here The essential amino acids are important for the growth of the child, and it is also important in the pregnant women. For the normal delivery. So you must know that for the growth of the placenta, these essential amino acids are important. So you must know that if these amino acids is seen absent in our body, or if the deficiency of these amino acids are seen, then there will be impairment in the protein synthesis. Means that no proteins are formed or synthesized in the body if the absence of essential amino acids are there in the body or in the diet. So you must know that the impairment of the protein synthesis can cause there, and due to this impairment of the protein synthesis, negative nitrogen balance is seen. What is the negative nitrogen balance? The excretion of nitrogen will be more than intake of nitrogen. So what are the proteins? Proteins are the molecules which will have carbon, hydrogen, oxygen and nitrogen. So these are the elements which are present in the protein structure. If the deficiency of essential amino acids are seen in the diet, then there can cause the impairment of the protein synthesis, and negative nitrogen balance is seen. And what is negative nitrogen balance? Excretion of nitrogen will exceed, you can say, will be more than the intake of nitrogen. So these essential amino acids are also known as nutritional amino acids. These are also known as nutritional amino acids. Now you see, what are non-essential amino acids? We'll see non-essential amino acids. So these acids are not seen in the diet, but they are formed in our body. So here the non-essential amino acids are AAA. If you want to remember the name of the amino acids, you have to just remember in the short form, and you have to write in detail in the full form in the examination. AAA, GGG, STPC. STPC. So this is the short form to remember the name. Here alanine, aspargine, aspartic acid, glycine, glutamine, glutamic acid, serine and tyrosine, proline and cysteine. So these are the non-essential amino acids, also known as dispensable amino acids. So these are synthesized in our body, but we do not get it from the diet. And two amino acids are there, the histidine and arginine. These are the amino acids called as semi-essential amino acids. Now, why they are called as semi-essential? Because they are partially synthesized in the body. Therefore, they are said to be the semi-essential amino acid. What are those? Histidine, you know, histidine is basic amino acid, you must know. So here this histidine and arginine, they are the semi essential amino acid. Now we'll see the classification of amino acid as per the metabolic activity or the metabolic classification of amino acids. We'll see now. In the metabolic classification of amino acids, you must know that they are glucogenic amino acids. What is meaning of glucogenic amino acids? The amino acids which gives rise to the formation of glucose in our body. Whenever glucose is needed, you must know that glucose is an important element which gives energy to our body, and it maintains the blood glucose concentration also through insulin. Glucose is maintained through the insulin. So you must know that whenever the lack of the lower level of glucose is present in the body, then you must know that the glucagon is an hormone which increases the glucose amount in our body. So here the glucogenic amino acids are those amino acids which forms glucose in our body. So they are the said to be glucogenic amino acid. What are those? They are the AAA, GGG, SCPV. So you have to remember in short form and you have to write in detail or in the long form in the examination. Alanine, aspargine, aspartic acid and arginine. These are the glucogenic amino acid. GGG, glycine, glutamic acid and glutamine. S, serine, then cysteine, proline and valine. So these are the glucogenic amino acids, and you must know the full form also. Now we'll see what are the ketogenic amino acids. Ketogenic amino acids are those amino acids which forms ketone in the body. So they are said to be the ketogenic amino acids, and they are only leucine and lysine. Leucine and lysine are the amino acids which are ketogenic amino acids which gives rise to ketone in the body. Now we'll see the amino acids which forms ketone bodies as well as glucose in the body. They are glucogenic and ketogenic amino acid. So these are TTI. So here the glucogenic and ketogenic amino acids are responsible for the formation of glucose as well as ketone. They are tyrosine, threonine, tryptophan and isoleucine. So these are called as glucogenic and ketogenic amino acids. So friends, I have explained the full classification of amino acid. First we have seen introduction, then what is the use of proteins in our body, and then we have seen the different types of the proteins, and we have seen the classification which is given by the metabolic characteristics, that is the metabolic classification also seen, nutritional classification, that is essential amino acids, then non-essential amino acid, then glucogenic amino acids we have seen. Okay friend, if you like my lecture, please like it, share it, give some comment and subscribe it, press the button. Thank you very much.